Hello everybody, this is Angie, and I am working on two projects. I just completed the two that you see there in front of the camera using the styrofoam pumpkins from Dollar Tree and quite a few things from the Dollar Tree with the exception of the burlap fabric in the back and my paints to paint it. Everything else came from the Dollar Tree, and the stand is, of course, not from the Dollar Tree. But I'll start by giving a shout-out to a wonderful crafter who did a DIY on this. Her name is Auntie Cuckoo, and I will put her YouTube name down on the bottom so you know the spelling, and you can check out her her video on how she did it. It's so easy. It is incredibly easy. I did get the, and they just got these in, the large frames from the Dollar Tree. As I said before, the burlap fabric I already owned. I got the welcome sign. It came in a set of three metal signs. I got that from the Dollar Tree. As I said before, the pumpkin is a styrofoam pumpkin like this, which I painted. The top part I painted white. And I cut 2 inches off that one to make it smaller. And this one is kind of like a brown taupe. It's a little darker than I wanted, but I only used what I had at hand in my craft room, the paints. This I got from the Dollar Tree, and this I got earlier in the year from the Dollar Tree. So that was my first project. Again, I will put her YouTube name on the bottom so you could watch her video on how she did it. Because it's really quite easy. The only hard part was cutting them. Now this was as simple as could be. Because first of all, I didn't even glue it together because I wanted to show you what it actually is. Looks like a little topiary. I've had this glass pedestal thingy for a long time. It's got a top to it. You could put cakes or serve whatever on that. But I'm using it as a display piece. And what the top part is, if you live next to, or not next to, near a Hobby Lobby, they had these white pumpkins. They're already white. They were $2.99 a piece. They're already on a pick. $2.99 a piece, and they were 40% off yesterday. So that means this week. I think I'm going to go and look for more. My problem was, I am kind of a perfectionist when I look at things, even if it's in the Dollar Tree. When they put these things together, they're in two halves. When they put the two halves together, a lot of them had very visible lines on them. So I went through like 30 of them to find two that looked really, really good. And I just love the look of this for like $1.80. And I did get the larger ones that weren't on picks. But anyway, that's another thing. But I got two of these. And what this is nothing more than, again, painting a Dollar Tree styrofoam pumpkin white. I kept the stem out, and I had I made quite a few wreaths, so I had quite a few of the leaves from the flowers that came out of Dollar Tree. I had quite a few of those left, and this is nothing more than those leaves, but I will just show you because When you leave the stem off, you have a hole in the middle. And that's just a painted white Dollar Tree pumpkin. And I put the stem inside and kind of pushed it. I haven't even glued it down yet because I wanted to see if I would like it, and I really do. And I will be hot gluing the leaves on that one for a display piece. Because I love topiaries, and I really like the look of this. So, if you're within driving distance of a Hobby Lobby, check out these white pumpkin picks for $2.99. And, of course, that's in the fall section. I think everything fall was 40% off in Hobby Lobby. Well, they overpriced it to begin with, so then they go 40% off to make it look like a great sale. But anyway, that's the two things I've been working on. Now, I have one other option on that welcome thing. This one is for me. This one over here is for me, mainly because I put it. I put the pumpkins on the sign a little too far to the right. I don't know if you can notice that. So I didn't center them completely the way I wanted to, but my sister's going to come over and choose the one she wants because I'm going to give her another option. And here's the other one. It's not even glued together yet. That's my wire. Okay, so it's going to say welcome. It's going to have the two pumpkins just like the other one if she wants it, and maybe a little bit of that grass, whatever they call that. But the other option I do have is to eliminate this and maybe put, I'm not doing this very well, that in the middle and some other things on the a sprig of must have fallen of something on the bottom to complete it. But it's going to be her decision on which one she wants and how she wants it, because of course I'm going to have two, so she could take her pick and decide how she wants to finish it up. But that's how easy it is to do a lot of things with Dollar Tree items. Like I said, the only thing I had to buy that was not in the Dollar Tree was the burlap fabric. It is expensive for what I used to call potato sack fabric, but you have all kinds of other options to do your background, and it doesn't have to be anything expensive. They even have like a wood grain looking kind of like contact paper in the Dollar Tree, which I think would be fun as a background. So let's see. If you have any questions about anything that I've shown you, please feel free to jot them down there. My name is Angie. Oops. I'm not doing too well, am I? I am Mary Scrapper 13 here on YouTube, and I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.